President of Keshav Memorial Education Society, Justice Sri L. Narasimha Reddy Garu, the Secretary of Keshav Memorial Educational Society, Sri T. Harihara Sharma.
Ladies and gentlemen, Honorable Justice Narasimha Reddy Ji on the dais, Dr. M. Y. S. Prasad, Professor Pradeep Kumar Neel Ji, it is indeed an honor for me to be welcomed to the Platinum Jubilee celebrations of the Keshav Memorial Educational Society. The Honorable Narasimhan Ji today, when he began his speech, said and quoted Mark Twain, who said that India is the cradle of human race, birthplace of human speech, mother of history, grandmother of legend, great-grandmother of tradition. He also added that our most valuable and most instructive materials in the history of man are treasured in India only. आज इस मंच से जब प्रदीप जी बोल रहे थे, नील जी बोल रहे थे, तो उन्होंने एक वेदना व्यक्त की और कहा कि आजकल टीचिंग का भी एक बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है. When I reflect on what Mark Twain said, he said that India is the great grandmother of tradition. Isn't it ironical कि जिस राष्ट्र का ट्रेडिशन ये रहा है कि गुरु शिष्य की परंपरा है, उस राष्ट्र में आज हम टीचर को रिट्रेन करने की बात कर रहे हैं, उनके कैपेबिलिटीज को एनहांस करने की बात कर रहे हैं. और आज अगर मैं मात्र सभागार में बैठे टीचर से और स्टूडेंट से बात करूं, आई वुड लाइक यू टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन द फॉलोइंग. अ टीचर टेक्स रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एट टाइम्स फॉर योर एकेडमिक ग्रोथ, but a guru makes you responsible for your growth. A teacher answers your questions, but a guru questions your answers, helping you find a new methodology to leading a much more prosperous and fruitful life. A teacher always demands obedience and discipline, but all a guru needs is trust and humility of the student. One can always find a teacher, but a guru has to find and accept you. And when a teacher finishes with you, you graduate with honors. But when a guru finishes with you, you celebrate life. So, आज अगर teachers ये संकल्प ले लें कि उन्हें वो गुरु बनना है जिससे wisdom प्राप्त करने के लिए, knowledge प्राप्त करने के लिए शिष्य पास आए, लेकिन गुरु के पास एक्सेप्टेंस की एक संभावना बढ़े, तो शायद जिस प्रकार से हमारे देश में विद्या का विस्तार हुआ था, वैसा ही विस्तार आज भी हो पाएगा. Mark Twain spoke about the fact that India is the grandmother of legend. आज जब मैं प्रसाद जी से बात कर रही थी, I asked him, isn't it ironical, sir, that gentlemen like you of esteemed stature celebrate Aryabhatta, but not many in our country, and especially the young, celebrate the wisdom of Aryabhatta. Prasad ji ne mujhse kaha ki Kriti ji, aap janti hain, aaj bhi DeConte calculations agar karna ho to normal calculus mein nahi kar sakte. Use karne ke liye Aryabhatta ke algorithm ki hi zarurat padti. Maine Prasad ji se poocha, Prasad ji, ये हमारे स्टूडेंट्स को कब पता चलता है कि आर्यभट्ट एल्गोरिथम कितना विशेष है? उन्होंने कहा, स्मृति जी, जब कोई मास्टर्स करना चाहता है मैथमेटिक्स में, तभी किसी को पता चलता है. इसका मतलब अ देश, अ कंट्री विच इज सो स्टीप्ड इन सच लेजेंड्स डज नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज आवर ओन इंट्रिंसिक स्ट्रेंथ एंड वी डोंट सेलिब्रेट इट. टुडे आई वाज जॉइंड बाय माय लीडर किशन रेड्डी जी एंड आई आस्क्ड किशन जी वन क्वेश्चन. ऐसे किशन जी, मैंने एक छोटा सा प्रयास किया था दिल्ली में बैठकर, उसका कुछ इम्पैक्ट हुआ? किशन जी ने कहा, प्रयास कौन सा प्रयास किया आपने? मैंने कहा, मैंने एक पिंगली वेंकैया का ऐसे कंपटीशन किया. मुझे आज भी याद है कि जब मैंने अपने सीबीएसई के चेयरमैन को बुलाकर कहा, आई वॉन्ट एन ऐसे कॉम्पिटिशन ऑन पिंगली वेंकैया, इज इट पॉसिबल? यस मैडम. There were one or two officers sitting around. They said, Pingali Venkaiya. So I totally agree that there is a need there is a need to remember our past. There is a need to celebrate our glory. There is a need to pay humble respects to those who laid their lives for this nation, dedicated themselves to this nation. While many a students Google a lot of international celebrities, I request them to find some time, some space in their busy schedule to respect those who gave up their lives so that we could live under one flag as one nation. मैंने अक्सर स्टूडेंट से पूछा, मुझे ऑफिस में अभी 2-2.5 महीने हुए, मैंने अक्सर स्टूडेंट से पूछा, एक स्टूडेंट मेरे पास आए जिसने कहा मैम मैं कैसे लिख रही हूँ, मैंने कहा किसके ऊपर, अ वेरी रिनाउंड इंडियन जर्नलिस्ट, उसके ऊपर मैं ऐसे लिख रही हूँ। मैंने जब जर्नलिस्ट का नाम सुना तो मैं स्तब्ध रह गई कि बच्चे जर्नलिस्ट के ऊपर ऐसे लिख रहे हैं। मैंने स्टूडेंट से पूछा कि बेटा इस साल किसको नौसेना मेडल मिला है ये तुमको पता है, बच्चे ने कहा नहीं मैम मेरी किताब में वो छप के नहीं आया है। वॉट कैन वी डू टू हेल्प आवर चिल्ड्रन लर्न मोर अबाउट आवर ओन कंटेम्प्रेरीज, देयर आर सो मेनी यंग वुमेन एंड मेन हु लीव देयर होम्स, हु लीव देयर फैमिलीज बिहाइंड। An example of it is Mr. Prasad sitting on the dais today. I told Prasad ji, you could not resist speaking in Telugu. He said, madam, I have gone to Paris and worked, but it's very rarely that I speak in my mother tongue. I use this opportunity to pay homage to my own mother tongue. And that is why when Mark Twain said that India is the birthplace of human speech, I am happy to say that we, through the MHRD, celebrated Sanskrit Saptah. For one whole week in the entire country, close to 90,000 students participated in Sanskrit Saptah. The same Sanskrit which helps us understand Aryabhatta's algorithm. But at the same time, since we are a nation of diverse cultures, since we are a nation which is blessed with various languages, as the MHRD minister and representative on this stage this evening, I will put forth to you a humble request that on the 21st of February 2015, we seek to celebrate Matrubhasha Divas all across the country. You being an institute of higher learning, I would humbly request you, though the instruction will be that Matrubhasha Divas is celebrated by all CBSE schools, all Kendriya Vidyalaya and Navodaya Vidyalaya, our endeavor will be strengthened if institutes of higher learning can also partake in Matrubhasha Divas celebrations. Ladies and gentlemen, since time is running short, I reflect lastly on a point which brings me a lot of despair. Mark Twain said, India is the cradle of human race. We the cradle of human race. How much of our education helps us reflect on the human being within? I share with you a story which I have heard and seen from my own eyes. In a district called Bid in Maharashtra, there were many a girl child that were killed in the mother's womb. There was one doctor who was very famous for doing stree bhruna hatya, but that doctor was never arrested by the police. A local social activist, when she spoke to me, I inquired, why is it that when everybody in the village knows that this doctor is committing hatya, that nobody arrests him? She says, we never have any evidence. Women sat together and spoke, and one pregnant lady accompanied the social activist undercover with a reporter to try and find some evidence. Two women went to the doctor, the pregnant lady and an undercover reporter. And they inquired, किसके पेट में बेटी पल रही है ऐसा हमें शक है, क्या आप हमारी मदद करेंगे कि इस बच्ची की हत्या हम गर्भ में कर दें? Doctor said, you give me 3,000 rupees, no problem. I will solve your problem. The journalist could not help herself and asked, कि डॉक्टर ये भ्रूण की जब हत्या करते हैं आप तो इसका करते क्या है? Once you extract it from the mother's womb, what do? How come you never get caught? The doctor in his arrogance told both the ladies, come, I'll show you something special in my clinic. He took both the ladies to one room in his clinic. He opened the room and he told the ladies, peep in. When the two women looked inside, 6 kutte andar bandhe hue. डॉक्टर ने कहा जब माँ का गर्भ निकालता हूं तो उसे कुत्तों को खिला देता हूं। घर की लक्ष्मी बोलते हैं हम बेटी को, और ये डॉक्टर कुत्तों को माँ का गर्भ खिला रहा था। इसका मतलब ये नरसिम्हन जी कि उस डॉक्टर को किसी मेडिकल कॉलेज ने डिग्री तो दी लेकिन इंसानियत सिखाना भूल गया। So I today can only say this and commit myself to only one thought, that the last time the National Education Policy was formulated was in the year 1986. India in 2014 is an India of new aspirations, is an India of new possibility, is an India that is being led at the helm by a gentleman who was born in a very, very poor family in a village, but through struggle became the Prime Minister of India. And this very Narendra Modi said that if our nation has to be a resurgent nation, we have to make in India, there has to be a brand label of made in India. And for both, we need our course correction to be done in our education policy. Hence, ladies and gentlemen, I'm happy to share here that through this government, we will initiate state-wise, region-wise, and a national debate and deliberation to formulate a new education policy that will study the ill effects of all the initiatives undertaken past, and that will also help formulate a vision for the future. So men and women of science, men and women who come from the background of humanities can help build a stronger, a resilient, and a more humane nation. Thank you so much.